Hello, this is Abraham Walker with Where to Live in Northern Virginia. I want to walk you through a four-bedroom townhouse in Kingstowne. I think it's important for us to kind of take a look at this property. Yes, this property is already sold, so you're not going to be able to purchase it. That's not the purpose of this video. I want you to get a good idea of the layout of the townhouse spaces and what you can expect in the Northern Virginia area. So this particular townhouse comes with two parking spaces. It's in Kingstowne. Kingstowne is the second largest planned subdivision in Northern Virginia. And so it comes with two assigned parking spaces, and there's also a visitor parking space right there. There's also street parking. So when you're looking at these townhouse subdivisions or townhouses in general, you wanna be mindful of what type of parking situation you have. And just because they have street parking here, which is cool, and you also have quick access to your unit from your assigned parking spot. The visitor parking spots, if you come during the day, like right now we're in the middle of the day, I think it's like 2 o'clock or 1:30 or so, in the middle of the day, the visitor parking spots are open, right? And so you're probably thinking to yourself, oh, this is great. That means that there's going to be open spaces when I move here. That's just not the case. When people come home, we don't know how many cars they have. So this is something you want to just keep in mind when you're moving to the Northern Virginia area. Now, this particular unit has, let's do this. All right. So this particular unit has three levels. So the bedroom level is going to be the top level. The middle level will be the living area where you have your kitchen, your main living space, and then the basement. The basement is going to be more like a rec room. This particular unit is special because these two windows we're looking at right here, this is actually a bedroom because you could actually get out of that window in the event that there's a fire, so we can count these as bedrooms. Now, what you're probably thinking to yourself, you know what? I'm moving from another location. I have to have a garage. Well, if you notice, so we have some garage units over there. We have some garage units over there. Now, those garage units are the same width as this particular unit. So that means that you're dealing with the same space up and down, right? So you have the same amount of space up and down. But the garage now takes up that space that you would have when we walk through this fourth bedroom. That garage space is essentially where the fourth bedroom will go. So you get to have your pick. Either you want a garage or you want some more space. You want some more storage space. You want a bedroom. You want a rec room, what have you. Okay, so let's go take a look at this property in Kingstowne. So this is a four-bedroom townhouse in Kingstowne. Again, Kingstowne is the second largest planned community in Northern Virginia. As soon as we walk in, we have a coat closet to our right here with the light. And so let me kind of point out the different space, right? So as soon as we walk in, this particular townhouse, we walk in on the second level. Some townhouses have you walk in on the basement level, the ground floor level. Some have you walk in on the main level, or the second level. The benefit of having a main level entrance versus a basement entrance is, well, it depends. You see, in this unit, you're going to notice we have steps on the outside and we have steps on the inside. If you get a unit, and this is just something that you can think about, if you get a unit where you walk into, like I live in a townhouse right down the street from here in Kingstowne, and my entrance to my townhouse is on the basement level. So that means that we only have one set of stairs in the entire property. This house has stairs outside and stairs inside. If there's an issue, it's an issue. If it's not an issue, it's not an issue, okay? When we walk in, let me go back. This unit here, the kitchen is in the back of the unit. You have two options when you're looking at townhouses. You have kitchens in the back, you have kitchens in the front, so like in this front living room area. Those are the layouts. It's rare. I have never seen, as of yet, now new construction models that were built maybe in the after 2007, 8, 9, some of the new construction, they'll have the kitchen in the middle, right? But these older units, this was built in the early 90s, the kitchen's gonna either be in the back or in the front, right? All right, so now we have this. So it kind of feels like an open layout, right? There's really nothing to break up the space, which is common with the townhouses. And let's look at the space towards the back here. Again, the middle space is going to be your dining room. The room that we're sitting in right now is more like it's not necessarily an eat-in kitchen area, because I take that back. Hold on. All right, there we go. This is all over the place. Okay, the way the space works is you get to really pick how you want to use the space, because it's really just a few boxes, right? So this particular floor has, if we count it, we have one, the kitchen is a box, two, this room that could be a dining room is a box, three, we have the room that is being used as a dining room is a box, four, the room that my clients use as a living room is also a box. You get to determine whether or not you use the space that we're in right now as your dining room, or that middle room right there is the dining room. Traditionally, the middle room would be your dining room, but a lot of people are moving away from formal dining rooms. So I wouldn't, if the new person is going to move into this unit, I wouldn't be surprised if they just have one table right here. They remove that chandelier-like light setup, and then they just use both spaces for living space. All right, so let's go to the kitchen here. Kitchens are going to be like this same type of setup. Either it'll usually be some type of version of a galley style kitchen, just reconfigured several different ways. So this kitchen right here, we have the sink and the stove on one side of the layout, or one side of the kitchen. It's not uncommon to actually see this refrigerator either where it is, or we'll see one of two things. We'll see this refrigerator maybe on this wall over here towards the end of the the end of the countertops, or we'll see maybe an island with the cooktop in the center island, right? Other than that, this is sort of the setup that you're going to get. It's very nice in this particular unit that my clients have a pantry in their kitchen, which makes for additional storage space. Now, let's see. Let's go out to, what we'll do is we'll do the, if I could find the right key, all the keys look the same. All right, let me find that key. All right, let's go out to the backyard. All right, so we have not necessarily a large deck, so you'll notice some of the other neighbors actually have larger decks. But what we are noticing, they left these. Okay. All right. So with the townhouse backyards, unless you have an in unit, you're going to have. What's up, puppy? So unless you have an in unit, you're going to have about the same. Hello. You're going to have about the same square footage in the backyard, right? This is a sizable lot, which is a nice addition to the space. So it adds a little bit more value to it. and it also has a walk out. It's going to be very uncommon to find a townhouse without a walk out. They do exist. It's just that they are rare. All right, let's just look out. All right, so townhouses in Northern Virginia, you're gonna have like some type of walkway here, depending on what type of the density of the community, and also the layout will determine like how much space you have back here. Is it that much of a big deal, like how much space you have in this alleyway? It depends. Because the larger these alleyways are, the more space you have away from your neighbor, right? So when you're on your deck and you have a townhouse that faces other townhouses, then you're going to see them. They're going to be that much closer to you. Okay, let's also talk about the view that you get, right? So as you see here, this townhouse backs up to other townhouses on the deck. You do have an option. One of the other options you have is you can get a townhouse that faces or backs up to the woods, a wooded area. Keep in mind, those townhouses are going to be rare, right? There are less townhouses that back up to the woods, more townhouses that back up to each other like this. Okay, let's continue our tour. Before we go upstairs, just want you to take a look at this half bath. Half baths in townhouses on this living area. So you would think to yourself, of course, all of the townhouses have to have a half bath. Really, this is depends on your price range. What price range are you looking in? If you're looking at townhouses that are below $400,000, there's a possibility that you can purchase a townhouse without a half bath on the main level. Then you just have to think about, okay, great. If I don't have a half bath on the main level, then where are my guests going to use the bathroom if I do entertain people? That's right, they're gonna either use your full bath upstairs in the, that's your guest bath, that services your guest bedrooms, or they will use the bathroom in the basement if you have a bathroom in the basement. So a lot of this depends on the price range. This particular townhouse it's a larger townhouse. So it has a landing, a sizable landing, as soon as you step up. And let's work from our left to our right. So you have two bedrooms in the front of the property. You have the full bath that services those bedrooms right here in this landing area. Then you have the master suite, the main bedroom, to the back of the unit. This is gonna be a typical layout. It's very, I don't know if I've ever seen a townhouse with the master bedroom or the main bedroom in the front of the townhouse, actually, now that I think about it. Usually you have, depending on the size of your unit, the size of your unit is gonna be a byproduct of the location and the price. Will determine like what size closet space you receive. Both of these bedrooms are actually nice size bedrooms, and this is, like I said, this is a larger townhouse. It doesn't really make sense to kind of talk to you about the price of this townhouse because the goal of this video is really to get you acclimated to what is a townhouse, what are you buying, what can you expect to What can you expect when you purchase a townhouse if you're moving from an area that does not have townhouses? I'm from New Orleans, and in New Orleans, we don't have that many townhouses. So when I moved here, I didn't know really what a townhouse was. I sold real estate in New Orleans, so I've seen them. They're very rare in New Orleans, but in Northern Virginia, they are very common based on your price range, right? So now we're going to the master or the main bedroom. You could fit a king in this particular unit. You could fit a king size bed in here. The size of the unit is going to, again, I'm sounding like a broken record. It's going to be dictated based on what your price range is. This is also a very large walk-in closet. One thing I want to point out in this closet, you see how they have the attic access in the closet there. Townhouses are not known for their storage space, so even in the closet. So we have a stand. So this unit does not have a tub. We just have the shower, standing shower, and we do have a double sink, and we also have a what is it called? A towel closet. The linen closet. That's what you call it. Excellent, Abram. My mind is blanking right now. Okay, so again, nice size bathroom, right? Is it the same size as something that you'll find in the single family homes? Some single family homes, yes, but comparing townhouses to single family homes is not fair. Don't do that to yourself. Townhouses are just a different type of housing product. So again, this is the bedroom level. On some of the newer townhouses, the ones that are built mid 2000, you know, like 2005, 6, 7, 8, 9, you would have the landing would be smaller. And the reason why the landing would be smaller is because they move the washer and dryer upstairs to the bedroom level. That's a new concept. You're really not going to find that in townhouses that were built before 2005, 6, 7, 8. All right, so now let's go to the basement. We're going to the basement. Let's grab these keys right here. All right. So now let's go to the basement and check out what you get in your basement area. Again, this is a 4-bedroom, 3.5-bath townhouse in Kingstowne. Kingstowne is the second largest subdivision in Northern Virginia. It's located in Alexandria, Virginia. All right, so let's start left to right. Let's start in your utility room. This utility room, in addition to having storage in the back here, it's also where your washer and dryer is located. Also your hot water heater, your return, things like that. I would say that this is a bit larger than normal. This is a larger than normal utility room. Also, there is some wasted space here, as you can see how at the size of this unit, but this is a challenge with townhouses. Let's say you move this space around and you made it just a little bit more efficient, right? Let's say you tucked away this washer and dryer into the back over there and you reclaimed this space, which is available to you. If you use that space, then you lose storage space. That's the game you're playing with townhouses. Every bit of efficiency that you add to the townhouse, you lose storage space. So now we're in the 4th bedroom here, right? So we're in the 4th bedroom. This bedroom is, this room is actually a bit of an outlier because you have this window here, which you can access or get out. So it has a closet. A closet isn't necessary to be considered a bedroom, but it is nice that they have a closet here. So this is a large room. Again, if my clients had one of their members of the household lived in this particular room, and so they were very comfortable. And what increased their comfort is the fact that there's also a full bathroom on the basement. I would say that Out of everything in this townhouse, the fourth bedroom and this full, the full bath in the basement, and this is a very, this is a large bathroom for a basement. These two features are outliers, not common. This space right here, this is a very common space to have this rec room, this not necessarily a living room, but maybe like a family room, just like a room you put your big TV in or what have you, game systems, stuff like that. And then let's look at the, let's see, okay. And then we have this walkout here. So remember what I said when we were first out here in the backyard? There, it's uncommon to actually not have a walkout, okay? The style of this walkout is actually the thing that's also not normal. When you have a walkout I think they call it a step-up walkout. With these step-up walkouts, you actually lose that space right there, right? So your backyard is actually smaller. This backyard doesn't really, it's not that big of an issue because it's a decent sized backyard, but this is just something you want to consider, right? Remember, this video is to show you this unit so you can get an idea of what you're purchasing when you purchase a townhouse in Northern Virginia. All right, so that's the end of our tour. So again, my name is Abraham Walker with Where to Live in Northern Virginia. This video serves two purposes. I want to show you what a four bedroom townhouse looks like with the layout you can expect. And I wanted to just have a conversation with you about your options. What options can you expect when purchasing a townhouse? And hopefully this tour gave you a good sense of, okay, great. So this is a townhouse. It's not that bad. It's not, you know, we've been living in a townhouse for a while now. We like it. My family likes it. We've adjusted to it. You too can also make an adjustment to it. If you have any questions about relocating to Northern Virginia, you can send me a, you can call me or text me, 703-539-2053. You can also shoot me an email to abraham@askawalker.com. Or we also, in the description of this video, we're going to have a perfect home questionnaire. The perfect home questionnaire will help you start the relocation process. We also assist individuals who actually live in Northern Virginia already, and they're just looking for a better location. They're looking for a better location. Maybe you've been renting a home and you just want to make a purchase. That's it. Hope this video was educational. I hope that it kind of helped you see what's available. And if you move to Kingstowne, then we'll be neighbors. I will thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace.